Welcome to Ms. Mojo, and today we're counting down our picks for the most iconic music videos Taylor Swift has given us over the years. I bet you think about me. Number 20, Teardrops on My Guitar. Let's start with this ultimate throwback. This was actually Swift's second music video ever, released way back in 2007. Drew looks at me. Teardrops on My Guitar is about a guy Swift has a crush on, and yet he keeps talking to her about another girl he likes. The video perfectly captures high school days and feels like a perfect representation of the emotional turmoil they tend to be filled with. Here's a reason for the teardrops on my guitar. We'd also be remiss not to shout out musician and actor Tyler Hilton, who plays Swift's love interest. She was a fan of his, and it's not hard to see why. Needless to say, everyone involved in bringing Teardrops on My Guitar to life visually does an amazing job. Number 19, Ours. The music video for Ours brings a mature perspective and context to love. Elevator buttons and morning air. It first premiered in 2011 and topped the charts on numerous country channels, including Great American Country. We can't say we're surprised. The video's storyline follows Swift doing regular stuff like going to work and captures the often ordinary, bland energy that can accompany daily office life. So don't you worry your pretty little mind. People throw rocks at things that shine. Throughout, she fondly reminisces on the relationship with her military boyfriend, played by Zach Guilford. In the end, the two reunite as he returns from service in an absolutely adorable moment. You have to admit, it's super cute stuff. But this love is ours. Number 18, Mean. You, with your words like knives and swords and weapons that you use against me. In one of her most empowering country hits, T-Swift gives us a banger of a song that calls out a jerk's bad behavior. The video was directed by Declan Whitebloom, who explained that it's a journey into multiple periods of time. Someday I'll be living in a big old city. Along with Swift and her band, two of the actors featured prominently are Joey King and Presley Cash, and they're all fantastic. We see a multitude of storylines focusing on people getting teased or mistreated, but those very same people come out on top, sending a message that you can always prove detractors wrong. It's an absolute classic that captures what it feels like to be undermined and continues to make people feel seen today. And all you're ever gonna be is me. Number 17. I Can See You, Taylor's version, from the vault. You brush past me in the hallway and you don't think I can see it. About 12 years after appearing in the clip for Mean, Presley Cash and Joey King starred in the video for I Can See You, from the vault of Speak Now, Taylor's version. In a unique twist, the video got its very first premiere at an Eras Tour concert. The exciting story focuses on a mission to save a locked-up Swift. In another epic twist, it also features the one and only Taylor Lautner. The concept is all about how Swifties have supported and empowered the singer to take her music back as she re-records her first six albums. That and all the Easter eggs scattered throughout make this impossible not to love. Number 16, Back to December. I'm so glad you made time to see me. How's life? Tell me, how's your family? The apology song that is Back to December is one of Swift's most poignant, and the video doesn't disappoint. It shows us a young woman, Swift, at home. She's unhappy, mourning a romance that ended due to her actions. So this is me swallowing my pride, standing in front of you saying I'm sorry. We also see her past love seemingly also upset. Soon, snow falls indoors, which takes the frosty, sorrowful energy underscoring the piece to a new level, and we feel the devastation. The emotional crux of the story, meanwhile, comes as Swift pens a letter that her lover reads as the video ends. The whole thing takes us on an emotional journey that's both gorgeous and heartbreaking. We see regret and hurt personified, making for a timeless result. Number 15, 22. It feels
feels like a perfect night to dress up like hipsters and make fun of our exes.
The iconic shirt, the cute heart-shaped glasses, the immaculate vibes, what more could you ask for? The 22 music video features the ultimate happy-go-lucky T-Swift aesthetic. It's all about feeling good with a focus on a retro style and party vibes. Sure, it may be simple, but it perfectly depicts Swift's ability to just have good fun with those closest to her. It's a reminder to cherish friendships and have a little dance party every once in a while. Every time we watch it, we're inspired to do just that. One second, we just need to find some cat ears. Number 14, We Are Never Ever Getting Back Together.
I remember when we broke up, the first time, seeing this is it, I've had enough.
We Are Never Ever Getting Back Together has an amusing, eclectic music video. And though it was first released back in 2012, we never tire of revisiting it. It shows Swift in various situations, and we get a glimpse into a past romance while her ex constantly tries to reconcile.
I'm really gonna miss you picking fights, and me falling for it, screaming that I'm right.
But the message is clear. It'll never happen. Like, ever. It's lighthearted and doesn't take itself too seriously while still delivering the highest quality. In fact, it was touted as being, quote, the world's first true 4K music video. Oh, and did we mention it was filmed in one shot? The people in this song may never be getting back together, but we won't ever break up with this video. Number 13, The Man.
I would be complex, I would be cool.
When it comes to Taylor Swift's music videos, this is among those that truly raised the bar and was the talk of the fandom when it came out in 2020. Apart from including a generous amount of Easter eggs, The Man features Swift herself, made up as a stereotypical businessman.
I'd be a fearless leader, I'd be an alpha type.
This was the first video that she directed completely alone, showcasing her artistic talents. Indeed, it perfectly captures the song's message about the double standards women face systematically. It was well received, and she notably won Best Direction at the 2020 MTV VMAs.
And I'd be the man.
We also can't talk about the Lover era videos without shining a spotlight on the one for You Need to Calm Down. We still haven't recovered. Number 12, Delicate.
Listen for the best. My reputation's never been worse, so.
Delicate's music video embraces the concept of being your truest self and takes it to new heights as Swift temporarily becomes invisible to those around her. With this power of sorts, she can do whatever she wants because nobody is watching her.
Is it cool that I said all that? Is it chill that you're in my head?
The video, directed by Joseph Kahn, embodies what Delicate is about. A new love and the fragility that comes with that, while telling a story about anonymity. It was generally well received, and many fans love it for all the adorable dancing in particular. Can we talk about that impressive split? Raise your hand if you had no idea T-Swift was that flexible.
Isn't it delicate?
Number 11, Style. If you're in the mood for a more conceptual, symbolic T-Swift music video to enjoy, look no further than Style.
Midnight, you come and pick me up, no headlights.
Directed by Kyle Newman, the clip doesn't have an explicit, obvious plot, instead relying on various scenes involving Swift and a beau. This, in turn, allows audiences to do their own analysis and come to their own conclusions.
'Cause you got that James.
A video without a clear-cut plot might sound risky, but the one for Style nails the execution, making for one of the best visual works in Swift's catalog to date. Simple yet nuanced, it still holds up all these years later and remains a testament to her creative range. Number 10, Shake It Off.
I stay out too late. Got nothing.
When life gets you down, you just gotta shake it off. This is arguably one of Swift's liveliest music videos ever. We just love seeing her dance and have the time of her life, and want to follow her lead.
'Cause the players gonna play, 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 and the haters gonna hate, 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 hate.
It was directed by Mark Romanek, but he explained that it was a true collaboration, and that the core premise came from Swift. The goal was to create an anthem for the so-called geeky and maladroit, thus encouraging them not to care about other people's opinions. What's even cuter is the fact that the folks you see next to Taylor near the end are actually Swifties. It was the star's idea to involve her fans, and what a great idea it was. Number 9, Cardigan. Vintage tea, brand new phone, high heels on. Cottagecore girlies unite, it's cardigan time. There's nothing better than the warm vibes featured throughout this video. Swift took the reins on this one, doing everything from directing to writing to styling, making it even more exciting. The story focuses on themes of self-discovery as we see Swift move through various scenes, which represent the start, demise, and aftermath of a romance. I knew you, playing hide and seek and giving me a weekend. It was shot amid the early days of the COVID-19 pandemic, so Swift and her team followed stringent protocols to keep everyone safe. Yeah, you heard that right. Taylor handled hair, makeup, and clothes herself, making this extra impressive. You put me on and said I was your favorite. The coziness doesn't stop with Cardigan, though, as Evermore's Willow continues in the same narrative universe and more than delivers. Number 8, Wildest Dreams. He said, let's get out of this town, drive out of the city. This music video almost feels like a mini version of a movie. The storyline focuses on a Hollywood romance and even has a plot twist, all done in almost 4 minutes. That's pretty noteworthy stuff if you ask us. Say you'll remember me, standing in a nice dress, staring at the sunset, babe. Starring is Swift herself, alongside Scott Eastwood. They bring to life two actors working on a film in Africa together in the 50s. The pair begins an intense relationship. But when they're back home by the end, we see that Eastwood's character Robert is actually married. To say we're invested in the tale being woven would be an understatement. The old Hollywood aesthetic that permeates the proceedings is just the cherry on top. Number 7, Bad Blood. Okay, we see you and your amazing budget. 'Cause baby, now we got bad blood. You know it used to be mad love. This music video has absolutely everything. Girl squad power, action, and a badass revenge narrative. Oh, and it's serving some pretty amazing looks, too. The Joseph Kahn-directed work was filmed in Los Angeles, although the location is described as a fictionalized version of London. The cast, for its part, is pretty extensive. Indeed, apart from featured artist Kendrick Lamar, it includes the likes of Selena Gomez, Cara Delevingne, Zendaya, and even Cindy Crawford, to name a few. This remains one of Swift's most loved visuals, with one critic even describing it as the Avengers of music videos. Oh, it's so sad to think about the good times. That and the more than 1.5 billion YouTube views it has amassed speak for themselves. Number 6, Love Story. You can't possibly talk about Taylor Swift without talking about the masterpiece that is Love Story. We were both young when I first saw you. The song and its music video probably led to many folks becoming Swifties, if they weren't already, that is. Trey Fanjoy directed the video, which riffs on the Romeo and Juliet narrative with a twist that unfolds in the lyrics. Basically, it gives us the epic romance many younglings dream of, adding both a medieval and modern flair to boot. Swift, of course, radiates a charming, regal energy throughout all of this. It's cute, timeless, and will forever be one of her top videos. It just has that Hall of Fame vibe, doesn't it? It's a love story, baby, just say yes. Number 5, Antihero. We love when Swift writes and directs her own stuff. Antihero has a fantastically put together acclaimed music video, showcasing what she does best when it comes to creativity and Easter eggs. Plus, the ghosts are hilariously adorable, and the underlying theme of her intrusive thoughts playing out in front of our eyes is ultra relatable. It's me. Hi. I'm the problem. It's me. We also have to give major props to the actors playing her fictional family, because they knock it out of the park. There's a lot to enjoy, like the multiple Taylors. The storytelling aspect in particular makes the video a treat, with the right balance of dark and light moments. It must be exhausting, always rooting for the end. It's quite the contrast to the shimmering Bejeweled video, isn't it? We could watch both of these for hours. Number 4, Look What You Made Me Do. Look What You Made Me Do was Swift's comeback song in 2017, and the music video was rightfully the talk of the town.
I don't like your little games.
So what makes it so great? First of all, there's a lot going on, and if you dare to blink, you will miss an Easter egg or two. It also depicts many moments in her career, ending with the utterly iconic scene featuring different versions of Taylor from her various eras. It's self-aware, pokes fun at the media circus that has often surrounded her life, and thus sees her reclaiming her story in a way.
I don't trust nobody and nobody trusts me.
This and the amazing video for Ready For It have us ready to revisit the Reputation era any day of the week.
Look what you made me do, look what you made me do, look what you just made me do, look what you just made me do.
Number 3, Blank Space.
Nice to meet you, where you been? I could show you.
Here comes another Joseph Kahn-directed music video, so you already know it's a masterpiece. The aesthetic on display is just pure perfection. The clip features Swift as this antagonistic person who's seemingly too much to handle when it comes to romantic relationships.
So it's gonna be forever, or it's gonna go down in flames.
That idea came from Swift herself, and Kahn happily took the direction and brought the vision to life. Visually, Blank Space's video has an enticingly dark, fashionable vibe. Not to mention, it's super entertaining to watch. It's a great example of Swift being able to make an unforgettable video that, like the song it accompanies, plays on the public's critiques of her.
But I got a blank space, baby, and I'll write your name.
Number 2, You Belong With Me.
You're on the phone with your girlfriend, she's upset.
This is a quintessential Taylor Swift music video. She's released plenty of other visuals since this came out in 2009, but somehow we always find ourselves running back to it.
If you could see that I'm the one who understands you.
For one thing, it's astounding to see Swift's immense superstar potential on full display as she brings two opposing characters to life seamlessly. On top of that, the story the video tells about a not-so-conventionally cool girl longing for her friend to realize she's the one for him is one many can relate to. Plus, the window signs and Junior Jewel shirt will never get old, the ending is swoon-worthy, and the teenage experience is represented flawlessly. It doesn't hurt to see Lucas Till from the Hannah Montana movie, either. We have zero notes.
You belong with me.
Before we unveil our top pick, here are a few honorable mentions. Picture to Burn. We love seeing Country Taylor do revenge. Mine. Directed by Taylor Swift and Roman White, this video takes us on a journey through time.
You are the best thing that's ever been mine.
I Knew You Were Trouble. It didn't win Best Female Video at the 2013 MTV VMAs by accident.
I knew you were trouble when you walked in, so shame on me, let out.
Begin Again. Filmed in Paris, it's a gorgeous representation of new beginnings.
In a cafe, I watched it begin again.
Out of the Woods, directed by the one and only Joseph Kahn, it certainly doesn't disappoint.
Are we out of the woods yet? Are we out of the woods yet? Are we out of the woods yet? Are we out of the woods?
Before we continue, be sure to subscribe to our channel and ring the bell to get notified about our latest videos. You have the option to be notified for occasional videos or all of them. If you're on your phone, make sure you go into your settings and switch on notifications. Number 1, All Too Well, the short film.
I walked to the door with you, the air was cold.
Where do we even start with this one? Everything changed, pun intended, when Swift released the 10-minute version of All Too Well, followed by the acclaimed short film, aka music video. Starring Sadie Sink and Dylan O'Brien, the mini-movie depicts a tumultuous relationship and what happens once it ends.
And I know it's long gone and there was nothing else I could do.
Swift put her heart into writing and directing it, and the result is a showcase of her skills when it comes to setting scenes and giving actors cues.
You charmed my dad with self-effacing jokes.
Absolutely everything, from the sets to the dialogue to the overarching narrative, is impeccable. All Too Well, the short film, is a mesmerizing work of art that everyone needs to watch at least once. Be right back, we're pressing play on it again for the billionth time. Calling all Swifties, what's your favorite music video? Let us know in the comments. Our song is a slamming screen door, sneaking
out, tapping on your window. Do you agree with our picks? Check out this other recent clip from MsMojo. And be sure to subscribe and ring the bell to be notified about our latest videos.